All right, welcome back, everybody. We've got our last eight races for you today in the Southwest bracket of our round of 64. 16 racers, eight races to close out the opening round of this tournament. Take a look at our first four cars. The number four car wouldn't be caught dead driving this thing. Gonna take on Global Pandemic, the 61 car, John. Fury against Brennan Nichols to open it up. The 12th car, Aren't You Glad to See Me, is going to take on I Can Lick My Own Eyeball. Actually, his kids didn't like the name of that guy, so we switched it to the Swamp Frog. So the Swamp Frog is going to face Aren't You Glad to See Me in race number 26. But first, race 25. Let's take a look at our matchup here. I wouldn't be caught dead driving this thing. Kind of heavy car, 34 grams against Global Pandemic. Number 61, Brennan Nichols. Brennan's on the A track, that's the outside in heat number one. Let's see how it shakes out. A quick lead from John Fury into the first turn here, kind of gives it up on the under over, and Brennan just takes it away into turn three and four, and he's going to put up a nice time, 4.5 seconds. I wouldn't be caught dead in this thing, is a full half second behind. All right, heat two. We've got Global Pandemic on the inside lane here, and he's just off the races. This isn't even close into turn one, and he is just going to cruise. Not even close. Two heats, all it took. Let's compare heat one and heat two. 0.05 in heat one, heat two, 0.24 behind. So not really even close in that second heat. Kind of gave it away. All right, number 12 car, Aren't You Glad to See Me? Shane Kennedy is going to face Mike Franchi in the Swamp Frog. Swamp Frog on the outside here, the A track. Let's see how it goes. Nice quick start from Aren't You Glad You Can't See
Oh
Me.
my gosh. This is
And they
tight.
are just, oh, what
Oh
happens there? Huge time from the Swamp Frog, 4.17. Look at Aren't You Glad to See Me? Just flips right over in there. All right, too bad. 4.17 would have done really well in a lot of races for the Swamp Frog. All right, he's off to a quick lead. Heat number two, under over, still ahead into turn number two. And Aren't You Glad to See Me? Once again, DQ'd. Let's just see what happened there. Same sort of thing. He digs in that front right tire and just goes ass over tea kettle. Here we go. Heat number three. Orange, You Glad to See Me gets DQ'd, and he will be out of this tournament. Very close race. Here it comes. Whoa. Orange, You Glad to See Me. 0.5. 0.05. Sorry. 0.05 of a second. He takes the checkered flag. Heat four. Orange, You Glad to See Me off to a quick start again to turn two. He's still ahead. And Swamp Frog on the inside trying to close it down, and he just does not have enough. If there was a little more runway on this track, he might have been able to close, but once again, it's 0.05. And Aren't You Glad to See Me puts down the Swamp Frog. So there's our first pairing in the Southwest bracket, round of 32. It's going to be Global Pandemic, 61 car against the 12. Aren't You Glad to See Me? Two fast cars. We didn't get an accurate time on Aren't You Glad to See Me, but Global Pandemic put up a 4.5 or slightly faster than that, so I'm looking forward to that matchup. All right, next four cars, the Quattro Blanco. You might ask why the number five car is called that. We'll get back to it. Against 45, Tracy Chapman, and then the 28 car, Grease Lightning, is going to take on the 37, the Police Bruiser. Interesting series of matchups here. We got some kind of funky cars, and let's see what happens. So we're on to race 27 of the opening round. Race 27. So let's see. Tracy Chapman, 37 grams heavy car against very light Quattro Blanco, which we can see has four white wheels. So there you go. That's where the name comes from. Took me a minute. Quick start from Tracy, and immediately takes a nosedive off the track. What happens there? Couple bounces on that opening straightaway. So we've got four of these little track connectors here from the Track Builder Unlimited fold-up pack in case you want to take this show on the road. And they tend to toss these cars around a little bit, especially if that car is heavy in the rear. You can see how much better Quattro Blanco takes that second bump than Tracy Chapman does, leading to her derailment and disqualification in heat number one. Heat number two, here we go. Quattro Blanco ahead on the inside to start on the under over. Pretty close neck and neck into Amen Corner when both of these cars, they come in hot. There's a lot of money riding on this particular matchup, I know. Tracy's able to rein this in, but Quattro Blanco, right front tire off, and that's going to derail him for quick DQ. But Tracy Chapman derails later down the track for two derailments for Tracy, one for Quattro Blanco. See how it goes. Here we go. Tracy Chapman on the that's all she wrote there. That's a third derailment for Tracy Chapman. That's going to be all you're allowed. Kind of sad. Up on your roof. Pathetic. And we'll give you the slow fade out punishment. Disqualified. Tracy Chapman, Quattro Blanco, the winner of race 27. Race 28. Here we go. Grease Lightning from the Good Dr. Beal against the Police Bruiser, Gino Donovan. Oh, look, there we go. Grease Lightning. Track A for Grease Lightning. Police Bruiser on your inside. Heat number one. Super quick start for the Police Bruiser. He's miles ahead into turn number two. Turn number three. Puts up a 4.12. He is 0.36 seconds ahead. Look at that. Reminds me of this. You know, Doc Beal's nickname in college was Kinnicky, so I think it had to do more with the hair than the other personality features of that character from the movie Grease. Heat number two. Here we go. Police Bruiser flying ahead. This is just an absolute blowout. Just like this car probably never going to drive again. And neither is this car. Pathetic. So, disclaimer time. Charlie derailed both races, both times after the Cruise Bruiser had crossed the finish line, so we just moved on without him. So anyway, there's your round of 32 matchup, the 20 car Quattro Blanco against the Police Bruiser, Gino taking on Sweet Tommy Rizicki in the round of 32. Let's take a look. Top half of the bracket filled out. So let's move on. We'll take a look a little deeper at our next four racers. One of my personal most anticipated matchups, the 33 car, the pretty green Lambo, is going to take on number one racing fan Jackson Bonikowski in Acid Wash. And then we'll have Allie Kellner and AC Slater take on Hannah Rockwell, Wind Not a Factor, giant, absurd, inappropriate spoiler on the back of Hannah's car. We'll see how that plays in. All right, race number 29. This is the one for me. Acid Wash, 29 grams, the old Firebird against the pretty green Lambo, kind enough to give us our track tour earlier in the series. Pretty green Lambo on the outside, Jackson on the inside. Here we go. Acid Wash off to a monstrously fast start into the first, second turn. He's way ahead. And there you go. Oh, pretty green Lambo does a lot to try and close it out, but Acid Wash just hangs on. And he'll go into heat number two with a 1-0 lead. Jackson on the outside to start in the second heat. Here we go. He's in nice position. And he derails going into that last turn. A little loaded heavy on that front tires. And he takes a tumble. So one DQ and one win for Acid Wash. He's going to be on the outside for heat number three. Here we go. Pretty green Lambo with a nice little lead into turn one. Turn two, you still got a little bit. Now they're neck and neck, and it's going to be very tight to the finish. There it is. Jackson Bonikowski edges out the pretty green Lambo, pretty young Tony, to win this race. I think we need the breakdown on heat number three here because just a thing of beauty from both of these racers. easily either one of them could have taken it. Let's see how they handle those turn connectors. Jackson gets a little more air, slows him down, so he's going to be 400ths behind out of that first turn into the first under over, 500ths behind, but he closes the gap into that second turn, and now Pretty Green Lambo puts up a 1.4 second final edge of this race. Jackson puts up a 1.33. Monstrously fast down the back half of that. That's how he won it. That's the breakdown. Jackson advances. Race number 30. Win not a factor. Hannah Rockwell against AC Slater from Ally Kellner. These are two pretty evenly matched cars based on the weight, based on, I don't know, everything except that massive spoiler. Hannah on the inside here, and she's going to take a very quick lead, and she's just gone. Off to the races. Puts up a 4.19, 4.19 very quick around this turn. Allie's two-thirds of a second more behind, and it just a slow finish for AC on that first heat. Running the tough track, though, so let's see what happens for AC running on the inside. Still a little bit behind here, but it's a slightly closer race. Not by much, though. Wind not a factor. The wind was not a factor because of that giant spoiler. Look at this. Look how smooth wind not a factor takes that turn connector versus Allie, who has a little more trouble with it. That's going to be it. Here we go. Acid Wash, Jackie Bono, going to take on the 24 car. Wind is not a factor. Hannah's traditionally done well in this tournament. I expect this to be a top-tier matchup for the round of 32, with whoever wins it looking to go very deep in this tournament. Okay, so that's it. We got four racers left, two races, and then the round of 32 is complete. The 16 car Johnny Chan's 40-weight special from driver Spurgeon Tanner, they call him Fish, is going to take on Coors Light, Ken McKenna. He's just a Coors Light kind of guy, the Silver Bullet. 57, the Shaggin' Wagon from Scuba Steve Santa Croce, is going to take on the only car with a nickname within its name, Vin This Economy Diesel from Mark Brulette. Apparently old golfing buddies, now they're going head-to-head for a spot in the round of 32. Here we go, race number 31, Johnny Chan's 40-weight special, Captain Spurgeon, Sturgeon, Fish, Tanner. Thanks for saving the earth. He's going to take on Coors Light. Spurgeon on the inside. Here we go. He's got a monstrously fast start. Very quick. Coors Light hanging in, though. Like to see this. This is a very close matchup. And wow, what a finish. Kenny just closes. I think we're going to take a look at this, but the Sturgeon, he loses this race literally by 11 inches. That's it. That's all it took. If this course was 11 inches shorter, victory would have gone to the 40 weight. Instead, we're going into heat number two, Johnny Chan race behind. Here we go. Coors Light with a quick start. He takes the lead in the first corner, but he's going to lose it into Amen. Turn three. If you're on the inside of turn three, you're most likely to win this. 4.32. The Sturgeon wins that by 500ths. 1-1 going into heat number three. And let's take a look at what happens. Johnny Chan on the inside, the Sturgeon, he's got the lead into turn one, and he takes a dive off Amen Corner. Let's just watch this like three times because it's a good wreck. There we go. Just inverted, headed off down toward the pool area. It's not going to win you any races. One DQ for Fish Tanner, one race each to the other two, and the Sturgeon, he wrecks again. Look at this guy. He's trying to go for a swim. There's a pool just off the deck there, and he's headed for it. Two DQs for the 40-weight special, heat number five. And Spurgeon Tanner, he needs to win here or he's going home. Either a DQ or a second place is not going to cut it. And neither is bombing down Amen Corner and ending up upside down on your hood. You're done. Let's see what happened. There he is. Look at that. That's iconic right there. Let's give him the fade out. That's it. DQ for the 40 weight. Coors Light gonna advance. Race number 32 to close this first round out. Vin This Economy Diesel Mark Brulette, 29 gram racer against the Shaggin Wagon from Scuba Steve Santa Croce. Here we go. Scuba on the lead into the first turn, and he's going to hang on to that right until he falls off at Amen Corner. 4.35 from Mark. Very respectable on that outside finish lane. And there you go. That's going to DQ. That's all you wrote for the Shaggin' Wagon in heat one. Heat number two, he's going to start on the outside now. He's a little behind into the first turn. Mark with a nice quick start into Amen Corner. He's just taking zipping down. There you go. Slightly faster. Second heat from Mark, 5.11 for the Shaggin' Wagon. That's not going to be a time that's going to take you deep into this tournament. Heat number three, Shaggin' Wagon once again ahead on the inside into turn one. Coming into turn two, he's falling behind. And if you're losing into turn three, ooh, Mark takes a little bump in the track there and he hits one of the uprights. And so that's going to be a DQ for Vin This Economy Diesel. A DQ each. Then this Economy Diesel with one win, the Shaggin Wagon with one loss. Shaggin Wagon on the inside here, neck and neck into turn one. Mark takes a slight lead, Amen Corner. He's going to be way ahead. And if you're on the outside of turn three, you're going to be inside turn four, the final turn. It means you just got less track left. So you're way ahead if you're ahead on turn three in that outside lane. So there it is, the 49 car, Coors Light driver Ken McKenna. He traded back and forth with the 40 weight special for a spot in the round of 32. And then the Sturgeon, you know, he just got very aggressive driving, you know, really tried to push it out. Amen Corner is a tough corner to take too fast. And three times in a row, he couldn't hang it. So Coors Light moves on, going to face Vin This Economy Diesel and driver Mark Brulette in the round of 32. I like both these cars. I think this will be a great matchup. I don't know how deep either of these cars have tournament-wise with 4.5-ish second finishes, but we'll see. Who knows? Okay, so there it is. This is it. Global pandemic. Going to face Aren't You Glad to See Me, Quattro Blanco, and the Police Bruiser squaring off, Acid Wash, and Win Is Not a Factor. And then Coors Light, and then This Economy Diesel. So there you go. That's your Southwest bracket for the round of 32. We'll see what happens. I mean, I think there are some very fast racers, a lot of very quick times coming out of this bracket. And we saw Acid Wash. Acid Wash did very well, and he was in the last race of the day. And then we had a lot of early races in this round. Global Pandemic was the fourth race of the day. Very strong showing there, so we'll see. And I mention this because what we found was over the course of the day, in the heat and the sunshine early in the day, the track was a little bit looser, a little bit more flexible, had a little bit more give, not only to individual lengths of the track, but the connectors, the walls, that sort of stuff. Versus later at night in the cold, things got stiffer, and you could see actually some of the connections, the gap widened because the track pieces shrunk. They were a different kind of plastic than those blue connectors that you see piecing the whole track together. So, you know, some of the more aggressive drivers, some of the faster cars had a little more trouble on the turns as it got later on. And listen, that's just luck of the draw. That's the tournament, baby. So if you're bitter about it, I don't know what to tell you. Drive better. See you next year. So there we go. Here's our Southwest bracket, round of 32. Here is the full bracket. This is the best photo I got, and it's not very good, so I apologize for that. But everybody should be able to see their car in the next round, more or less. A lot of matchups out here that I'm personally looking forward to. Love to see Shaquille O'Teal, and my other car was a real POS, facing off in the Southeast bracket. Also really looking forward to, but will there be chicks there against Smoke Pork Shoulder up in the Northeast bracket. Pikachu and Florida Stanley's going to be a highlight. We've got Devin facing his sister-in-law, JoJo, in the number one versus What is that, 46 matchup? That was the first races we watched in this tournament, and so I'll be looking forward to seeing them face off. Also, we've got Jim McCall in the last of the V8 Interceptors. He's going to be facing Phil. I think that's going to be a very quick race. I think either of those guys we could look for deep in this tournament, down into the final four. So a shame they're meeting in the round of 32, but again, that's how the tournament breaks. So I think that's kind of the fun of it. And Rosie, glad to see her. She made it through in that pickup. Not a lot of unique shaped cars made it through the first round. Obviously, you got Slytherin up there, one in sudden death in rare fashion. Love to see that. Then we got Rosie in the pickup, and then we got those two boats down there, Ed Heumann and Steve Pettis, and one's in the station wagon, the other's in the SUV. I mean, that's really like a great second round matchup. Would have been a great first round matchup, but was just as good in the second round. But also looking forward, obviously, I've mentioned this a few times, but Jackson Bonakowski in that Firebird, great opening race, and he'll face a tough competition with Hannah Rockwell, and that giant spoiler is 90% of the car. But Jackson, number one fan, thanks for watching. Okay, there it is. That's all I got for you. Actually, no, there is one more thing. If you, like me, were so unfortunate as to have lost in the first round, well,
sorry about that. I guess the only thing we can do is play you a song.